Hello and be welcome to this short video tutorial regarding our TwinCAT Scope with the topic how to do a first record. As you can see, we are in the Microsoft Visual Studio, so we have your solution, a TwinCAT project, which should be a very basic simulation of a milling machine. And I like to scope now some values of this milling machine. Therefore, I make a right click to the solution, add new project, and then wizard will be open, and I can choose in the TwinCAT area different kind of templates, scope templates, for the experts who knows what they like to do. But I recommend you, if you have no experience, to choose the measurement wizard, because this is the best entry point. You get a new wizard. Then you can choose between border plot, filter designer, analytics, or for scope view, and we choose, of course, the scope. Then we have two different perspectives, so we can configure it from the perspective of the variables, but also from the point of view of the charting. I choose now here for the second one, and then I can choose my chart type. I choose here, in this case, the standard YT chart. I can choose my target system, and I can choose the port for the symbols, in this case the PLC port. Then I can browse into this port and can choose different variables. So here I go to the milling or machining center, the milling part of the machine, and then I choose the spindle speed and also the machine current. And then I have a preview here. I can directly create this as a configuration for scope, or I can add here in the wizard some more charts. And I choose this option. Then I can take the existing chart or make a new one. I like to do an additional YT chart and go ahead with the variables. And if I do not know the exact variable name, I can take here the filter. I like to scope now some temperatures, therefore I type temp here, and then I can easily choose all the variables with temp in the name. Yeah, I'm searching for my tool turret, and there I have for the three tools of the milling machine the different temperature sensors. And I like to add them now to my configuration. I have again the preview, and now I create this configuration. A measurement project is added to the solution. I see my scope, and if I click on one of the items, I see my charting, and then I can directly start my record. And so the recording is starting with, in this case here, with the temperatures of the different tools. So just some clicks and you have your first record started. Of course, you can stop the record. When the recording is stopped, you can add more variables at any time using the target browser, which is now available as a separate tool window instead of its integration in the showed wizard before. So you can also browse into the variables again, and then you may choose some additional variables, and by drag drop you can add it to the existing configuration. If you drop them on the scope node, you will have an additional chart with a new axis, and then you find both channels in this axis and you can start the record again. That was it for now. Thank you for watching and see you soon. Bye bye.